the heart of your reimagined plan then is electrification of both of these brands, Land Rover and Jaguar. Do you feel you're at the forefront of this wave of electrification, or are you having to run to keep up?
No, I think you can see that Jaguar was pretty much ahead, you know, with the I-Pace, so it's not completely new in our company. At the same time, reimagine for us, it's a vision. It's a vision of modern luxury by design, but with a strong factor of sustainability, and that's why we call that the responsible modern luxury by design. This is the vision for the business. It's also a vision for the brands, of course, and as such, the electrification of the whole future Jaguar portfolio by 2025 and of the Land Rover portfolio before the end of the decade. And in fact, 6 vehicles in the next 5 years will be proposed with BEV for Land Rover. So you understand that it's a quite high rhythm, but we have the technology, we know how to do it, we enjoy it already, and so we know what is the journey. But the important factor is that we are, at the same time, creating a huge simplicity in our platforms, architectures, and that's going also to help a lot to make sure to be on time.
OK, and let me ask you a little bit about the simplification and help us understand what's happening to some of your production facilities. Looking at Castle Bromwich, for international viewers, that's in England, in the West Midlands. Are you saying that that facility is no longer going to make vehicles after a certain point? And what kind of use will you find for it?
Yeah, it's clear that we are going to continue to produce our nameplates in Castle Bromwich till the end of life of these vehicles. And then it's clear as well that we want to use all our facilities better for the new vehicles to come. And that's why, concerning Castle Bromwich, we are exploring all ways to repurpose the site. Fortunately, we have a certain number of activities, very valuable activities, which are too much scattered over the Midlands in the UK. And that's the reason why we have a significant opportunity to reorganize, to restructure all that and transfer these activities in a possible repurposing of Castle Bromwich. So far, we make very valuable things there in a very efficient manner, which is the goal.
OK, so what are the types of activities you might do there, and what year will vehicle production there cease?
Well, actually, the new Jaguar vehicle will come by 2025, with the renaissance of the Jaguar brand. So that gives you more or less the period of time at which all that is going to happen. But we have also some activities like the special vehicle operation. It's an example, very valuable, where very much high appetite from our customers for the bespoke finish and trims of our cars. And this is the type of offer that we could very much envision to move into Castle Bromwich.